I thought it would be funny to make a video from a different reality. One where VLC Media Player has a no-clip button that lets you explore your videos in 3D. My jig was up immediately, or more like, the jig didn't even make it off the ground. Fully jigless video. So, yeah, this effect is actually Gaussian splatting, a 3D reconstruction and rendering technique developed last year. I have a link to the software I used at the bottom of the description of the video, and also in the description of this video. Some cool people have pointed me to newer techniques developed more recently. I have not tried these yet. Question: can you make a tutorial for this? Not a helpful one, no. I barely know what I'm doing, but sure. So first, I activate my gsplat Python environment. I assume this is the one the download page recommends, but I don't remember. Next, I copy and paste this script and run it on my chosen input video, maybe with a different frame rate, but I'll get what I can. Next, I go down a few directories and edit and run this batch file that I made. And then I wait. Then, whenever this is done, assuming it didn't explode, I rename whatever output that gave me and copy and paste this code. And if I'm lucky, I have a 3D scene here. Question: is there an easier way to do this? I have no idea. Question: can you elaborate? No. Question: can this be done with any video? Hypothetically? Yes. Practically? No. You can kind of think of this as a program that looks at the parallax motion in a given video and does some math to figure out what 3D shapes would create that parallax motion given the movement of the camera. If it can't find any, like, real parallax motion, then it's not going to find anything. Question: can you noclip into XYZ video? I don't know. Maybe. Generally, if the camera is moving around a 3D space and nothing else in the scene is moving, then you can G-splat it. The second requirement might be obsolete now thanks to newer research, but I haven't tried it. I never did show what happens when somebody is actually moving in the shot, did I? Well, check this out. Question: what if you did this with a cartoon? Most of the time, it just breaks. This can be true for real footage as well. Apparently there's some research going towards fixing the cartoon problem at least. Question: aha, so that's how you did that effect. Maybe. Surprisingly, I've been cooking multiple different methods for 3D extraction. And rendering. I think they're fun, so I'm gonna go over them. The final shot in my water video uses Gaussian splatting, showing that, yes, you can use video games as an input. Same for this shot in my video game linguistic relativity video. I made the wavy effect with some of the slowest code I've ever written. I will not be sharing it. Looks really cool on real objects though. From the video game graphics video, I had to bury this shot in effects to hide how artifacty it came out. This, from my otaku video, is an entirely different technique. Basically, I used depth anything to generate a depth map, then extrude each pixel of the image into 3D space based on the value of that depth map. Check out these unused scenes from my otaku video. The link to Death Anything is in the description, but you're on your own after that. Good luck! Something I haven't used yet is this. Mesh Estimation Converted to Particles. This uses instant NGP. It's a neat effect, almost like a painting. I look forward to it, maybe. Oh, also, this program that I used for the latter two effects is called Tool 3. That's Tool with two L's, and then a 3. It was designed specifically for me, despite what the creator might tell you. For most people, I don't know if I'd recommend it over Blender, but I love it. These videos here were made entirely using the thing, plus a ton of other random graphics here and there. And that's all I've got for you. Hope it answered some sort of question. Okay, bye.